Hey guys, Zuko here. No, fuck that.
Hello, Zuko here. But I guess you probably already know me, sort of.
Yo, what's up? Forever Rock here, and welcome to a new video. I'm sorry I haven't uploaded in a year. I know there's a couple shit that I fucking missed. But that is okay, because I moved places, and it makes me happy. And I got a room here, and I'm all cozy and snuggly. What we doing is, we're doing a randomizer playthrough, so to say. Oh, before I actually make the world, though. It's gonna be crazy. It's just gonna be crazy. I make sure the randomization only affects the bosses, which is gonna make life way more interesting. We also add in a couple more mods in here to make life, I don't want to say easier, but make this shit more nuts. Great, alright, bet, let's finish. That took forever. My plan for this playthrough, whether I like it or not. What? Our spawn is the fucking jungle, dude. Oh, dog. Okay. Well, fuck my life, I guess. Being Moon Lord, but we gotta be being. Fuck. Wait, hold on. hold on. Got a bone bed. Our first drop was the bone bed. Yeah, I wanna be the Moon Lord. It's something I never really done, even in vanilla. I was close to being him in vanilla, though. Which plops. And then, well. It's a question of should I make a quick NPC spawner, because I feel like it would be much needed. I need a slime. Or give me a painting instead, but I still, okay. So, just so I don't royally fuck myself. Slime will also drop slime and random item, which is a fucking blessing. So if you need slime, so that you can get yourself MP. Oh, you hit hard. So you can get yourself a NPC, or make yourself NPC houses. It's still gonna drop it. But this is awesome, fucking strat right here. Just keep on killing slimes. Hopefully, you get something good. Even though we got painting in the bed frame for now. God! Give me something good to eat. A unicorn on a stick. Okay, well, we got a unicorn on a stick. Oh, no jungle. Oh, God damn it, dude. And a bat. And two jungle slimes and a fucking bat. We're still gonna die. I hope you know this. We're gonna die. We're dead. Watch him start beelining for my base. Oh, that's exactly what it was. Where the hell did the chest came from? What the item name fake new chest 12? Oh, it's a fake chest. Dark Mage Booster increases magic damage by 25%, max mana by 50, and mana regeneration greatly. How do I use it? Is it a consumable? No? Google. Booster's the only drop of anti-buff is active. They provide a variety of buffs to Dark Mage. So, the anti-buff we deleted, we can use these boosters on. I'm gonna go to the right this time. And then after that, we can get an unlimited. Wait, hold on, I don't want to die real quick. But we got something that says unlimited star anise, 130 throwing damage. I mean, it's something to start out, but plus we can't even eat this till we get in hard mode, can we? Yep. Whoa! This is why, okay, so this is why I said I was gonna wait to tell you what I wanted to say earlier. Every playthrough on this world, the type of damage, not damage, the stats were randomized, and the item, projectile and were randomized. So this is why this is looking like that, and it got the key of flight. Well, let's just run through you real quick. Oh my gosh, yes, that's so lucky. We really need to get to hard mode, dude. Fuck you. We got angler pants, increases fishing level, whatever. Die trader's turban, that's cool. Got 8,150 jungle mimics. 6,279 fucking fish bait. We call potions we always gonna need. Lesser human potions we always gonna need. Oh my gosh, bro. We need to make ourselves an arena. Another chest. Summons a skeleton mages. I think that's late game. Open all shadow chest. Oh my god. Unlimited wrath. Oh, bruh. Magic lava dropper. % of all critical chance. Get offensive universal combination. Gives offensive modded combinations as well. Hiding visual. Disables thorium and spirit buffs. Lower the critical chance reduction of Mimo Repassite and expert mode. Oh, this is whack, bro. Okay, fuck it. We're going home. To the motherfucking desert that I completely forgot about. I mean, once I get the rest of the storage, so to say, I don't really need to worry about this. But since we got a shit ton of mimic chests, I want to do something about that. But first things first, since we have 33. Oh. Well, shit. This is my first ever jungle playthrough. Holy shit, yo. Really need a puff in the bottle, though. I hate that we only have a trap chest. What I want is to find my first fucking mage weapon. And living tree. There won't be any gnomes here, so it's not like it's gonna fucking solve anything, but still. Just wanna press B so fucking bad, but I don't wanna click B. Fuck it. I didn't even know. Hold on. Oh, I can't do any buffs since I have the universal combination. Or I can't do any buffs because of anti-buff? So, the buffs doesn't really fucking matter then, yeah. Cool. Give me the loot. See, Mandible's Blade. Oh, we got a fucking fishing rod now, yay. Maybe we could use the bait for something. Overloaded mump. Oh my god. Pumpkin moon. Simulation control unit, exclusive pop-up. Left click, change between day and nighttime. Right click to enable or disable rain. Or sandstorm desert. Hell yeah, dude. Whatever. It's better. Don't need any of these, guy. Anything else better down yonder? Uh, Haha. Was just working a base, dude. Hey, it's me from the future. I'm still editing this. I'm not gonna lie, this is like the third day of editing this video. This is a 2-hour video, and I realize it's, I only got it down to 1 hour and 30 minutes, and, I'm gonna try to make this good for you, but this is have to be a two-parter, and it's going to be a two-parter, and I'm sorry for that, so stay tuned for the next one. I'll make sure to upload that one next, and yeah, thank you. Like, comment, subscribe.